Okay, this went over into a second part video. All right, so at 6:12, Weeping Willow 2 Daily Data News coming at you. So at 6:12 p.m., according to them, I'm not verifying that, they ended up stopping me down on 2nd Street, and this sheriff's department deputy, and I stopped, of course, pulled over to the left in a little parking area at the courthouse, and he approaches my door. He said, "I stopped you because you don't have a plate." Well, I knew that was an absolute lie, because you can't see where the plate is on the back end of my automobile due to a huge wait a minute. A huge wheelchair lift that's on the back, and besides the lift, it's got a great big covering, a solid black covering that's over top of it to protect it from the weather. So that tipped me off as far as McCarty Towing Service and Auto Repair, that ended up calling to tell them this, because you can't see it. And I've taken pictures of it, and I do believe I've already put that up on YouTube. But he asked for a license and insurance. I said, "I don't have either one." I said, "But I do have some paperwork to give you." And I asked him, could I get it, because I didn't want him shooting my ass. So he said, "Yeah." So my purse is sitting right there, and I pulled out my documentation of being an American state national. See, folks, I expatriated. Nothing that the government does or the state does has anything to do with me. I am an American. I can use, if I choose to rely on the Constitution and the Bill of Rights and civil liberties, you know, the 1964 Civil Liberties, the Rights Act. So anyway, but I don't use those, all right? I'm free. I'm a woman. I'm the living flesh, flowing blood. And, you know, that's all to do with commerce, commercial, maritime, admiralty, all their crap, which has nothing to do with me. The document that I handed to him proved this. Now, I've got a lot of documents, and they're going to be getting copies of all that. And then I handed them the right to travel, which had numerous United States Supreme Court cases in there, proving that the police and all these, you know, characters have nothing to do with we the people. And y'all need to wake up to that fact. But anyway, he said it didn't have anything to do with him. Now, he and his little boot camp that they go to, you know, to be instructed in what's supposed to be law, but they're all learned up in the statutes. It had nothing to do with law. They wouldn't know law if it slapped them upside the head. But they think it's law, okay? So while they're at their little boot camp, they're being told anybody that gives them paperwork, it's a sovereign citizen BS, okay? Well, it has nothing, that is not what I'm about. I'm an American state national, and they needed to learn that. They needed to read those papers, but I don't think they have yet to date. I really don't, or at least that's what one of the deputies said. But I've got about 11 pages of United States Supreme Court cases that proves the fact that they have nothing to do with we the people. And they'll be getting a copy of that too. Copies, rather. And the organization that I am now a party to, American State National Assembly for Kentucky, which has just been up and running of late, but it's in almost all of the states in the Union, the Republic. And common law is being instigated or installed back into our country. And, you know, common law has always been there. And I'm not talking English common law, which is spoken of in the Constitution. I'm talking common law, the Ten Maxims. I'm talking about the Father in Heaven's law, okay? Total different, two things different, absolutely. And so they ended up pulling me over, asked for that. I told them I didn't have it, I didn't have to have it. And I had my tape recorder going. I had my video camera going, sitting in the seat of my automobile. And I had my granddaughter on the phone. And I'm screaming at her before they even approached my door, telling her they're going to kill me. I was convinced of it. Here it is at night. They've been stalking me for years. They, you know, have done every despicable thing that you could imagine when it comes to stalking somebody and, you know, following them down the road. You know, I've sent numerous emails to Sheriff Keith Kane, and I don't think he's, maybe once somewhere over the years he ever responded, I'm not sure. But, you know, he's proven himself to be the traitor that he is. And these people are absolutely rogue. Okay? They don't know jack anything about the public law, which they're supposed to be following. They don't follow what they're mandated to follow, which are the United States codes, codes of federal regulation, and even their own statutes in the state. You know, these are private corporations, people, and they're all parties to the court system. All right, and Judge Dale, which that's not his last name, but that's his first name. I forget his last name. But anyway, he ended up releasing a 5-page document PDF file, which I have remarked on and did videos on it. But he's a retired justice of the United States Supreme Court, which ended up verifying that they are all, and I'm talking judges, clerks, cops, and attorneys, are all a party to a criminal enterprise that's worldwide, not just here in America. So anyhow, I have put all this stuff out, covered it in numerous videos. And so the incident that happened on January 16th, they were, this one deputy that was at my door ended up telling me to step out after he called for a second backup. Now, I'm totally disabled. I have a walker in the back of my seat, and I can't walk anywhere without additional severe pain. I have bones splintered off in my left leg and my ankle. There's no ankle joint. I need to have my right knee replaced as well. So, you know, walking is not my strong suit. Bending is not a strong suit. And sitting straight up is not a strong suit. I do that in this chair with supports, okay? So here they were going to arrest me. Really? 69-year-old woman, totally disabled, and you're going to arrest me and throw me in the clinker. I don't think so, because you see, having the knowledge on them not having jurisdiction over we the people, put me in there, it would have been and was grave harm, physical abuse, assault and battery, and you know, a few other things. So you know, they will pay the price for this. That's a guarantee you. So y'all need to look some of these cases up. Christie versus Elliott, Boyd versus U.S., Chicago Motor Coach versus Chicago, Adams versus State, California versus Farley, People versus Battle, State versus Robinson, State versus Armstead, Thompson versus Smith, Kent versus Dulles. Ibid Gibbons versus Ogun. Penn Hollow versus Dones. Cooper versus Aaron. Miranda versus Arizona. Marbury versus Madison. Mulger versus Kansas. Miller versus Kansas. U.S. versus Minker. Brady versus U.S. Siegler versus Railroad Company. Shearer versus Cullen. U.S. versus Bishop. Sapp versus Tallahassee. Michigan versus Duke. Collender versus Lawson. Owen versus Independence. Louisville versus Motley. Burns versus Superior Court. Aces versus U.S. Griffin versus Matthew. And Bonanche versus Massachusetts. And U.S. versus Will. These are all cases that have ruled in favor of we the people, okay? That they have no jurisdiction, they have no party to do anything with you or to contract with you unless you consent, which I immediately told them I did not consent. And the second unit that showed up, Deputy Ashby, was trying to break out my truck window where I was sitting, which would have splattered all over my face and my eyes. I already have three eye diseases. I damn well don't need glass shards shot in my face. And he had no right to do it to begin with. So anyhow, a third unit shows up, and I don't know if that was a sheriff's deputy unit or if it was a cop, but they joined the chase too. So when it cleared the front of my automobile and was to the right, facing the wrong way in the traffic, because it was a one lane heading west, he was heading east, I shot out and took off to come home. And I wasn't having somebody break out my damn window. And so I came home. And of course, they were hot on my tail. And there wasn't very much traffic at all. And I, you know, got around a couple of vehicles or went right straight down when they pulled off to the right and the left shoulder. And I shot home. And they accused me in their paperwork saying I was driving 70, 75 miles an hour, which is BS because I could not handle a car at that speed. There's a railroad track you have to go over down there. And no. See, they were all standing outside of their units. So when I pulled out and sped off, I mean, you know, it was like 35 miles an hour on the regular speed. I don't know what the hey, the speed I was at. I didn't have time to look at the speedometer. But it daggone sure wasn't no 50, and I might have been driving 45 and a 35, but that'd been about the extent of it. But I don't admit to that because I don't have any way of knowing. But they, in turn, were driving 70, 75 miles an hour while everybody had to scurry and get into their units, you know? So I was already way down the road by that time. But let me find... Okay, Boyd versus U.S. The court is to protect against any encroachment or constitutionally secured liberties. Well, you know, I don't hang on the Constitution. That's not me. I hang on to common law. Okay, but these are cases that they're supposed to abide by. All right. This Christie versus Elliot. Traveling in an automobile on the public roads was not a threat to the public safety or health or constitute no hazard to the public, and such a traveler owed no other duty to the public, e.g. the state. He, she, and his, her automobile have an equal right to and on the roadway, highways, as horses and wagons, etc. This same right is still substantive rule in that speeding, running stop signs, traveling without a license plate or registration are not threats to the public safety and thus are not arrestable offenses. Okay, Chicago Motor Company versus Chicago. And Lagarde versus Chicago. Boone versus Clark. Highways. All right, the use of the highways for the purpose for travel and transportation is not a mere privilege, but a common and fundamental right which the public and natural people cannot be deprived. Adam versus State. One may come to the aid of another being unlawfully arrested, which that's what they planned to do there, but they did do that in my driveway after they broke out the right side of my truck window. I shattered it everywhere, all over the dash, the floor, the seat, the back seat. It's everywhere, in the yard, in the grass, on the driveway, and I can't get it up, okay? I cannot bend to get all that glass up, people. All right, so that means I have to hire somebody with a dad-blamed vacuum cleaner, I suppose, to go and suck it all up, which is going to take some money to do that, which I don't have. All right, back to this. One may come to the aid of another being unlawfully arrested, just as he may where one is being assaulted, molested, raped, or kidnapped. Thus, it is not an offense to liberate one from unlawful custody of an officer, even though he may have submitted to such custody without resistance. California versus Farley. Speeding, driving without a license, wrong plates, no registration, no tags, etc., have been held to be non-arrestable offenses. So you see, I was terrorized and abused and scared out of my wits because I knew they wanted to take me out. And I think the only daggone reason they didn't was because I was on the damn phone with my granddaughter, okay, who was recording everything as well. So they have stolen, without a warrant, stolen my tape recorder and my cell phone as well as the video camera. And they've had it since January the 16th. So I was told a couple of weeks ago it'll be another month before I can get it. Now they want, me, which is my family name is Bo Hannon. They want me to account for the all capital name, and I don't know how they got to social. I mean, it's some real BS going on here, folks. But I didn't have any ID on me, and I don't have to prove anything to them. But I failed my own teaching. I screwed up. I talked to them, you know. I did. I should have ever opened my daggone mouth. I should have just said no contract and shut up, you know. But I didn't because I was scared. I've never had a ticket. I've never been in trouble. I've never anything. And I damn sure have never been arrested. But they were out to get me as they had been stalking me for years, and they were trying to find a way. So they found their way with the a-hole that ended up coming and stealing my truck off my property a year and a half ago because of the next-door neighbor and the neighbor across the street. All right? So this is the big scenario. This is everything from point A to point B on how they have been doing me as they've been doing me. Okay, people versus battle. Traffic infractions are not a crime. State versus Robinson. An illegal arrest is an assault and battery. Well, they sure did that to me. So attempted to be restrained of his liberty has the same right to use force in defending himself. Oh, I can see how that'd go. Pull something out to protect yourself. We're going to shoot you right there where you sit, as he would in any other assault and battery. State versus Armstead. The right to travel, the right of mode of conveyance, the right of the locomotion are all absolute rights, and the police cannot make the void the exercise of rights. Thompson versus Smith. The right of a citizen to travel upon the public highways and to transport one's property thereon, either by carriage or automobile, is not a mere privilege which a city may prohibit or permit at will, but a common right which he/she has under the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Kent versus Dulles. The right to park or travel is part of the liberty of which the natural person, citizen, cannot be deprived without due process of law under the Fifth Amendment of the United States Constitution. Well, you know, the Father gave us this earth, and I'll travel wherever I want to, you know, but a citizen, I'm not. I'm an American state national. But I don't hold under the Fifth Amendment and all that, because I didn't swear no oath to it, you know what I mean? And this due process, they don't have the right to take your common law rights away from you. I bid Gibbons versus Ogun. All right, particularly Article 1, Section 8.1 and 9.1. Persons are not the subjects of commerce, and not being imported goods, they do not fall within the meaning founded upon the Constitution of a power given to Congress to regulate commerce and the prohibition of the state for imposing a duty on imported goods. Penhallow versus Dones. Administrators define government succinctly. Governments are corporations. Inasmuch as every government is an artificial person, an abstraction, a creature of the mind only, a government can deal only with the artificial persons, the imaginary having no reality and substance. Cannot create or attain parity with the real. Cooper versus Aaron. No state legislator or executive or judicial officer can war against the Constitution without violating his undertaking to support it. But that's what they all do, you know, they're oath breakers, which makes them Class D felons. Miranda versus Arizona, where rights secured by the Constitution are involved, there can be no rule making or legislation which would abrogate them. Marbury versus Madison, the Constitution of these United States is the supreme law of the land. No, it isn't. It's common law. And any law that is repugnant to the Constitution is null and void of law. Mulger versus Kansas. Under the United States Republic's constitutional system of government and upon the individuality and intelligence of the citizen, the state does not claim to control one's conduct to others, leaving one the sole judge as to all that affects oneself. Miller versus Kansas. The claim and exercise of constitutional rights cannot be converted into a crime. U.S. versus Minker. Because of what appears to be a lawful command on the surface, many citizens, because of their respect for what only appears to be a law, are cunningly coerced into waiving their rights due to ignorance. All right, you know, that brings to mind the Miranda right, okay, which they didn't bother reading to me. All right, but the Miranda right, you know, anything and everything that you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Do you understand your rights? Well, as soon as you say yes, you just gave them up. That's a two-part question, folks. All right. And understand means you're understanding, you're under them. You are literally standing under their rule and thumb. Okay? That's what that means. They have absolutely tricked us and duped us into believing that they had authority over us when they don't. They're under maritime admiralty statutes and all this BS, all right? Which doesn't have a damn thing to do with we, the living people, all right? So, anyhow, do you understand? So, you're understanding. You're standing under is what that is literally saying to you. So, anyway, keep your mouth zipped. All right, Brady versus U.S. Waivers of constitutional rights. Not only must they voluntarily, they must be knowingly intelligent acts done without sufficient awareness. Okay, Ziegler versus Railroad Company. If any question of fact or liability be conclusive, presumed against him, this is not due process of law. See, now that's where they screwed up with me. They assumed I was claiming to be a sovereign citizen. This is where the boot camp ignorance comes in, that they think anybody that's handing them papers is just automatically written off, ignored, and there you go. Well, they're going to get a big wake-up call. Shearer versus Cullen. For a crime to exist, there must be an injured party. Well, there's no injured party. I didn't harm anybody coming home. I didn't destroy any property. Okay, corpus delicti. There can be no, sanction or penalty imposed on one because of this constitutional right. U.S. versus Bishop. If you have relied on prior decisions of the Supreme Court, you have the perfect defense for willfulness. Sup versus Tallahassee. Reef versus City of Philadelphia. Lynch versus North Carolina Department of Justice. It is